Welcome back. So,
If I or a loved one has, God forbid, has a heart attack or a stroke, these are the things that I would be quick to do, and you can just take from it what you will. So essentially, a heart attack or a stroke, as we've mentioned before, is due to, for the most part, a blockage to blood flow. So blood is going from let's say, from the left to the right. Yours is reverse, I guess. But blood is going from the heart to the lungs, or to the legs, to the brain, to the kidneys, or to the heart itself. There's a blockage. So basically, the parts after that blockage are not getting enough nutrients, are not getting enough oxygen. The heart and the brain are specifically, especially sensitive. So they have a, I mean, it's about 4 minutes, I believe, in the brain, and in the heart a little longer than that. But anyway, the bottom line is that things go wrong. So in the heart, you have a heart attack. If the heart doesn't cease beating completely, it's going to be beating erratically. The same way in the brain too, the parts after the blockage will be damaged. Now, there's a window period of 6 hours in which the doctors can intervene and reverse that blockage, and also hopefully reverse the damage. In this country and in many developing countries, we may not have that kind of luxury. So this advice, what I would do, are based on that fact. I probably would do the same thing too, even in a developed country, because there are certain things that we can do that really can boost the survival of that tissue that has been affected. So first things first, heart attack or stroke, get the person to lie down or to recline in their seats. Shouldn't panic. Don't move around. Just lie down, recline in your seat. Make sure you call for help. If there's an emergency number they have access to, by all means call that as soon as possible, even if you're not sure. If a person is clutching his heart, or she's sweating profusely and she feels weak, remember in previous episodes we said that woman's example, how a woman's heart attack shows up, is quite different from a man's heart attack. A man may have a gripping chest pain. A woman may not have that pain. She may just be feeling uncomfortable. She might be sweating. She might be nauseated. She might be vomiting. So if you sense those things, especially in a woman who is above the age of 50, assume the worst. Assume it's a heart attack, so you don't lose valuable time. What cardiologists recommend is taking 300 milligrams of aspirin, chewing that. What aspirin does is that it helps to reduce the likelihood of clots in the system. I want to add to that, because if you've been following our program, you know that I speak a lot about nitric oxide. Nitric oxide is a gas that your body produces that helps to dilate and improve blood flow. As a matter of fact, most people who have had cardiovascular conditions, most people who have strokes, are deficient. They've proven that, are deficient in this nitric oxide. So I gave my example. I think I've mentioned it a few times in the past. When I was in my early 30s, I used to have this gripping pain in my chest from time to time, and I couldn't go see the cardiologist because I didn't have money. I was a student then, and I didn't have insurance in the US, and so I had to study and find out what would help. So some of the things that we've mentioned include higher than normal doses of vitamin D3, vitamin C, L-arginine, L-citrulline, magnesium. So I found a complex, a nutrient complex that had all these things together, and we put them together. And so I began to take them, and like I said in previous episodes, that helped with the pain, and had, if at all, I had very few symptoms after that. So you need, or your loved one needs, and I believe everyone should have this access, should have these nutrients in store on the ready. In fact, you should be taking it every day to keep your cardiovascular system healthy. But in the event of a heart attack or stroke, you need to be taking good amounts of those nutrients, because those will help in the blood flow. So while you're in admission, or while the doctor in the emergency room is trying to do that, as long as you're conscious and you can drink, be sure to take those things in as much as you possibly can. And then, of course, in the recovery period too, that's very important, because healing periods from a heart attack or a stroke can take weeks to years. And so especially at the crucial, those times that are as close to the event as possible, the days following, you need to take a lot of those things. I mean, that's my personal belief. In addition, you also want to keep on checking with your doctor and ensuring that he's taking the aspirin and the other medications that they need to take. If blood pressure was an issue, you need to ensure that your blood pressure levels are normal. And this, anytime there's a stroke, what I found out is this, anytime there's a stroke, the blood pressure regulation is highly affected, because again, the brain deals with this, all this, it regulates all these different things. So if the brain is affected, the blood pressure regulation too will be affected as well. So be sure to take nutrients, be sure to take the omegas, which are very helpful also in dealing with inflammation. The body responds to injury by producing inflammatory compounds by the immune system, and so your body, you need these omegas to help to heal and quench and quell that all that noise. So it takes a while for the brain and the heart to heal, and so again, it's very important that you provide your body or your loved one's body with these things that will help in the healing process. I hope that has served. If you have any questions on this, please punch them in your social media or on any of the platforms, and we'll get the answers to you. Thanks again.